Over here we have Begonia maculata, very popular plant for growers because of its beautiful leaves and the white spots on it, and it's also got a nice red underside. Now this plant is a shade loving plant, and it likes it relatively moist. Give it a very thorough watering one time, and allow the medium to dry out a little in between waterings. Okay, next we have a Monstera bossigiana variegated. The white parts of the leaves actually have almost no chlorophyll. We have to grow this in right shade away from the direct sun because the whites of the leaves can get burnt very easily. And this plant is a shade loving plant, which is actually very good for apartment dwellers. All you need to do is to grow it near the window where it receives a very very bright light and maybe some morning sun. This succulent is known as Cyprostemma vetiformis. It's from Somalia and Kenya. It's also a cordyceform. A cordyceform means it actually has a big fat caudex like this. The caudex contains and can hold quite a bit of water. What we usually do is we water it very thoroughly and allow the potting media to dry out about 90% before we water again. This succulent is a Dostena gigas, and it's from the island of Socotra. It's also considered a cordyceform because of this fat base that you have here. Now it's a sun-loving plant. One should not allow it to dry out too much between waterings. If not, the leaves will start turning yellow. This is a Mammillaria compressa CV yoga. It's a mutated cactus. As you can see, it kind of looks like a brain coral, so to speak. This is a sun-loving cactus, and without enough sun, the plant will not be as red as you see it now.